hard, actually.
Let me see if I could check out.
In the art.
Okay. Hannah, what did you use to make your Seder plate?
The shank bone.
Nice.
What else? There's the maror. I put it away.
Yourself. Did you make it out of paper, Hannah?
I made it out of paper from Mira. I made bitter herbs, parsley.
Nice.
Bitter herbs, parsley, shank bone, crab roast set.
You got it.
Lettuce. A lot. That's a
hard boiled egg.
Hard boiled egg.
Yeah.
Those are all mommy.
Great. So everybody, Matt is going to do art is starting in about 5 minutes. So we are going to have some of the boys sign on too, and everyone's going to.
I don't like grid because I use it.
So right now is the time if you have some. Mary, you said paper and markers, right? But it's going to be drawing.
Okay, mommy.
Yep. So if you have some time to go get you some paper and some markers, right now is the time to go get it. So we've got about 4 more minutes until we're going to start.
I have to go.
Okay, Robin. Okay, thank you so much for joining us. It was great to see you, Robin.
Bye, Robin. I miss you.
They can hear you.
Thank you.
I'll see you soon.
Yes.
Mara, can you smile?
I'm going to
Everyone smile.
Smile.
Cheese. Okay, good. I'll send it to people. I'll send it around.
Hello.
Hey. Oh my gosh. Everybody's here.
Hi.
Welcome.
Thank you. Oh, hi, Jesse. It's me, Matthew. Can you see me?
I see Jesse there too.
Yes.
Hi.
Come on,
bro. Jesse. Look.
I bring my beauty.
Dylan, that's a. This is Dylan. She doesn't usually come to Friendship Circle because she's two.
Hi.
But you can hide all our friends.
Dylan, nice to meet you.
Say hey to Matt. And sometimes you guys see Bryce. He's here too, but I think he's feeling shy.
Bryce.
What kind of paper should we get?
So any paper will work, any markers, crayons, paints,
white,
whatever most convenient. We're doing something today called abstract art. So there's no right answer and there's no exact way, but I'll be doing a step-by-step drawing and it's going to look something like this.
With colored circles.
Yep.
There was an artist that did circles like that.
Sorry, this is Wassily Kandinsky.
Yeah.
We've heard his last name, Kandinsky.
Yeah.
And he's very famous for being one of the pioneers of the first abstract artists. And this is his picture called Concentric Circles.
Concentric, I know it because, yeah.
One inside another.
Mm-hmm. I work at a preschool, and that was one of the enrichment projects. We were having kids do circles.
Yes. But if you feel more like making ovals or triangles or scribbles,
yeah.
If your abstract art, you get to be the artist today.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yeah,
mommy.
Got it, mommy. This app, so you're all set. Okay, guys, I'm going to sign off, but I just wanted to say hi to everyone, okay?
Bye, Lauren. We miss
you.
Bye.
Bye,
I'll see you later. Lauren.
Bye. Bye.
Bye.
sign off too before you start the art, but good to see everybody.
Bye, everybody. Bye, Sherry. See you.
Bye. And I hope to see you next time we're on Zoom.
Yes.
Bye.
Bye.
There's friendship stuff online. Can I mark it?
Want to stay and want to just.
Hey, Jeremy.
I know that voice. That's Bobby Dua.
Hi.
Bobby Dua. I saw something.
June is walking outside. Hi, June.
Hello, everybody.
What's it like out there?
Beautiful.
Of course.
Little chilly, but beautiful.
Okay.
Nice. Yeah, you look chilly, but beautiful.
All right. Want some art? Okay, here. Take a pen, come. Mark color.
That's awesome. That
was just... It isn't. I'm going to do a square.
So cool.
Pretty color.
Great bee.
It is a great bee.
Wait a minute. It's a great bee.
Happy birthday to you.
Maybe you'll tell me whenever you have to, you know, whenever everyone's on.
Yep. So I don't know who all is going to come on for our regular programs, but I like to give it a minute just as people figure out the tech. Hi, Avi. How are you?
Oh, hold on. It's
Happy.
Avi, hi. Hey, Matt.
I want mommy.
Avi.
I'm just listening to Mara. Is that okay?
Yeah. Okay, there you go. You can talk.
Hey.
Hey, Avi.
Hey.
Move this back so they can see your whole head. Hey, Matthew, here. Why do you keep doing that? You keep moving closer. Oh, now I see Daniel's here too. Hi, everybody.
Hi, everybody.
Okay, so Mara, if you want to get everybody started just with picking out, you know, getting all the materials ready, yeah. I think we can definitely start with that.
What material?
So, friends, it's going to be a very flexible project today. That means that you can use any materials that you have. You could use pencils, crayons, markers, and we're going to work on paper. And you guys can use a piece of paper just like this,
okay,
or construction paper. And I'm going to work and show you guys step by step on this paper right here. Can you guys see the easel?
Okay, look, Jeff.
And what we're going to make today is a picture of sort of boxes with circles in circles and circles, all different rainbow colors. But if you want to make something different, that's great too. So you can just use the time to color with us, or we can go step by step together. So first you'll want to take your paper, and I'm going to use crayons today. So everyone can hold up. Let's see. I'm
so
okay.
All
right, take your log out.
Want to hold up. Hannah, what will you use?
Do you want which one, crayon or marker? Okay.
Let's see, what's Jeremy going to pick? I think
he's
picking
a marker.
He's got a marker. Matt, what do you have to use? Let's see. I'm going to scooch over to the screen too and see more friends.
Look.
Avi, what will you use to make your project?
Wait.
All right. So once everybody feels ready. Oh, yeah. I'll move this closer. Maybe you guys can see it better. All right. So a first step we're going to do is we're going to make some lines on the paper going from side to side.
Okay.
So you can hold your paper vertically up and down or horizontally. So we're going to make lines and lines and three lines across the paper.
That's called lines and lines and lines.
You're going to do the same thing. Lines.
Three lines starting.
So we're doing the same thing.
Yep, if you want to do the same thing, you can follow along, Matt, step by step, or you can do a free project.
I can do the paper.
And then after we do the three lines, going side to side, We're going to do three lines going from the top to the bottom.
Two.
One.
Three. Two. Now make three lines like this.
Okay. Two. Just a little closer so you can see.
Oh, wait, one more line. Three.
So we'll have lots of boxes. And if you want to count along with me, we might have different amount of boxes, but I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Thanks, Bryce. 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. I have so many boxes. You might have more boxes. Or you might have less boxes, but that's okay.
Whatever. Or the same amount.
Oh, thank you, Bryce. Bryce is also helping me draw. You might have the same amount, 16.
What do you think?
Wow, Matt, I love your grid. And we can call that a grid, right? So when Candace was making his concentric circles, he started by making these lines and lines. So next, you guys can take some different colors and get them ready. I'm going to take yellow, red. I'm going to look for maybe I have brown, blue. Oh,
I have green.
Nice. Matt has green. I found a green too.
Sure.
Red.
Yeah. What color is it? What color?
So you guys can take your time and you can put some crayons next to your paper so you have them ready. Some rainbow colors. Oh, I'm going to find orange because I think
orange. All right.
Let's also use orange. And does anybody want to share? They can raise their hand and I think we can unmute. The colors of the rainbow? Does anybody know one of the colors in the rainbow?
Purple, blue, green, yellow, orange, and red.
Red, orange, yellow, green, blue, violet.
Amazing. Hannah and Matt, thank you guys so much for sharing the colors. So check it out. So you can use whatever you can see in Kandinsky's circles. He used all different colors and all different patterns. So the next step is to take your rainbow crayons in your hand. I'm going to start with orange. And I'm going to make a big orange circle in one place, a little orange circle in another box, a medium-sized orange circle. And then I'm going to change colors. But my first step is going to be making all different orange circles wherever I'm in the mood to in the box. Thank you so much, Bryce. This is awesome. Bryce is also making art. So you can make them in any box that you want, and you can make them any size that you want. The circles are going to go inside and outside of each other. You guys all feel good about that step, doing the first color circles?
Yes.
You can always come back to your first step. If you're in the mood to hold it up and see and show everybody, you can do that too as you go. Or maybe you could do it at the end if you're in the mood. So after orange, I'm going to pick red. So I'm going to take my red crayon and I'm going to make a little tiny red circle.
Come on, Jeff.
In one. And I'm red. Even going to do another red take circle red. On the outside.
That's okay.
And then in my other empty
red.
Box, I make
red.
Red circle.
Red. Good.
And in this one, I'm going to make a thicker red circle, which means I'm going to use my crayon like this and circle around to make the line thicker. That means wider. See, it's bigger here and this is thinner. So you can make also different thicknesses in your circles. Some can be thick and some can be thin. And maybe I'll make another medium circle. I'm going to fill it in right here and you can sort of scribble it in. Circle. Now I'm so curious as we're drawing, because I don't get to always notice in class, how many people are using their right hand? I'm using my right hand. But Bryce, who's my son, just made this circle and he uses his left hand.
Cool.
Some friends I know can even use both hands, so that's really awesome, however you're doing it. So I did some orange circles. I did some red. I'm going to next. Yes, Bryce can do some things with his right hand, too. He cuts with his right hand. He wants you to know. So I'm going to pick my next color will be purple. So I'm going to draw a purple circle, let's say, in my empty box. And then in this box where I have a thick red circle, I'm going to draw a thick purple circle inside and still leave a little hole to color it in. next. Can you guys see okay? I think the light might not be the best where I am. So our job today is going to be to continue making all different, in one empty box, I'm gonna make two thin purple circles. And then in my orange one, I'm gonna make a little dot on the inside. But you guys can make your circles however you like in whatever pattern you like, because you are the artist. And I have how many more empty boxes? 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm gonna leave these open on my on the bottom. So I have 4 empty ones. So I'm gonna pick brown next. And I'm gonna make, can you guys see me? I think I, hey Dylan. We're gonna make a thicker brown, I'm gonna make a thick brown circle here. Oh, and it's you can say hi. Come, you want to help me color circles? Okay. And I'm going to make a brown dot in this one. And I'm going to make a thick brown circle on this, in this box. Thanks, Dylan. Dylan, do you want to color the middle? Next, I'm going to use some green. And Dylan's going to help me. Yeah. Can you color, Dylan, this? You can show the friends. Color this circle. She's gonna color, yeah, nice. Circle, circle, circle. Beautiful, amazing.
I made one.
You did, and maybe we can do a green little dot on the inside. Right, so we're gonna continue to build our
big.
You can use a big green, just keep working your circle, circle, circle. You got it. Nice, Dylan, thank you. And then I'm going to put a green circle.
A greeny-ish.
Nice, a greeny-ish. Okay, nice. And we're going to keep filling in. We're going to make circles outside of circles and inside of circles. And it's going to soon fill up and continue to look more and more like this, right? Circles and circles. And you can use all different inspiration. And that means pictures to give us ideas. That's inspiration. So next, Dylan and I are going to use some yellow. Here, Dylan, want to do a circle here, yellow circle? And I'm going to do a yellow circle here. Dylan's working on a yellow circle. Bryce. Bryce, would you like to do a yellow circle right here? Bryce is going to do a yellow circle. I'm going to color this a thick ring, like a big O. It's like a little letter O inside my orange one. And then I'm going to do red inside my yellow.
Yeah.
Thank you, Dylan. And then maybe let's even do some purple.
Brown and black.
Oh, yeah, Dylan did some brown. Nice. I'll do purple over here.
I feel good.
All right, Bird, you could just take a break if you did a lot of work.
No, I did it. I'm helping you. Don't help me.
Dylan's coloring purple. And if you guys have paint, do you guys remember from school when we use crayon and then we put watercolor on top? What happens? Does the watercolor go on top, or does it? One second. Or does the watercolor, or does the crayon show through?
It turns out like this.
So Bryce did crayon, and then he put watercolor on top, and the crayon showed through. So you guys can do another project after, or you can add watercolor if you have it to this one, and the crayon will still show through, which is so amazing.
Well, you did this one.
So we're going to keep going with our circles. Do you guys feel good? Does anyone have any questions about their circles?
And guys, we play hide-and-seek every morning.
Not
here,
Jill,
just scooch out of the way. One sec, so friends. Nice, and Dylan's going to continue making these different rainbow circles. And I'm going to add some blue to this one.
Is that paper?
I like to put blue sometimes next to orange. They're complementary colors.
I'm the worst.
And see, look, Your colors can look all different ways. There's no right way to do it. Bill, can you work on this one, making some circles in there?
These are circles.
Are they?
Yeah. I'm going to do a little thing. Coloring in the rings.
Until you want to be finished.
Oh, friends, I'm going to add a little black to some of my circles. Yeah, I kind of like how that looks. You guys like it?
Wow.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Hey, Lumpy.
I'm here.
Thanks, you have guys. This coloring.
I'm here too.
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, check. Dylan, can we show the friends this circle that you've been working on? I really, really like it.
No!
Watch this.
Here, Dylan, just switch to the side because, look, you can show the friends. Dylan's circle looks rainbow. So they can, the colors can mix together too.
What?
Then I'll add yellow to this one. Dylan will add thinking about some colors. I'm gonna add. See, this one I made a lot of skinny line circles, and this one I was making thicker lines. Dylan was blending hers together. Thanks, Dill. I'll put some orange here.
And red.
And then if you guys are in the mood, oh, Dylan wants to show you an example. So after, it looks like Kandinsky colored the outside square different colors, and you can fill it in too. So after you're done making your concentric, your circles and circles and circles, you can color in the rest of the box. Nice, Dill. You can color in the rest of the box too. So this one, I could color around my circle with scribbly lines to fill it in. Can you guys see me? Oh, I think I'm doing the wrong side.
You know, I'm
getting so now the whole box is filled in with color.
My grandma made a circle.
Sure. You guys, and I'm gonna work on the inside of this circle now, making a thicker black circle. And then, yeah, Dylan, yours is really cool. I agree. And then red, and I'm gonna color the outside of this box red.
Wait,
what? So it's really becoming a lot of rainbow circles in all different patterns. Yours has so many patterns. Oh, this one, see this one, guys, I'm gonna leave just a little bit of circles and I'm gonna color the rest a lot in red. I'm in the mood to do red and I'm gonna make scribbly lines. Color it in.
Oh my God.
Wash me, man.
It says right here, don't change all your dude, it says right here, don't change the
color. Oh, okay, you can take a break if you need.
I don't need to.
Okay. Oh, I see Harry now.
Hey.
Friends, is anybody in the mood to, we still have time to color, but is anyone in the mood to show, hold theirs up and show how it's going?
Yeah.
Oh, Dylan wants to show where she's at. If you don't, that's great too, because that means you're focusing so much. I'm gonna color this one purple around the edges.
Well, that looks good.
Oh, good, you can do it too.
I want to.
Oh, then you're the artist, so you can make your own decision what you wanna do.
I only want to do this.
I love that. That looks amazing. Yeah, if you wanna be done, then you can start working on the box next to it.
Oh, no.
You're not gonna change my head.
You're
doing it
now. Down here, I'm gonna do one all purple on the inside, and I'm gonna make a teeny
tiny red dot on the inside. So tiny.
And I'm going to make a screen over this.
Oh, I hear you guys scribbling away. That sounds like music to my ears.
Jeremy.
Yeah.
Jeremy's scribbling.
I can start by playing Jenga. I know how this starts, but how do you start building
this? Do you remember? And Dylan just gave me an idea because, Dylan, can you scooch so I can show your circle? Perfect. Because she has a lot of colors mixed that are kind of blending together. So I'm going to make this area on my square circle green and blue together. And you can do that as a choice also. Don't cut yet, Dylan. So it's coming along, right, guys? It's a lot of work. Your arm might feel tired, and if it does, you can just shake it out,
I go to school, my arm feels so tired.
Yeah.
Because sometimes, like, we have to do, like, dumb things.
Sometimes you guys are writing and coloring so much, your arm gets so tired. Then you could do a little stretch. Oh, wrist stretch. Does anybody want to remind us what kind of art is this? Realistic art or abstract art?
Abstract.
Oh, Grace wanted to share what it is.
Abstract.
Abstract. Uh-oh. Does that mean that it looks like something exactly or that it just represents different things?
It just represents different things.
Yeah. I wonder what Kandinsky was thinking about when he made his circles. Now I'm thinking about these circles as being all my friends in these little boxes on Zoom. Maybe this is Anna, and me, and Matt, and Jesse, and Daniel.
In the back.
Oh, wow, so many friends. And Jeremy, and Harry, and Avi.
And Noah.
And your friend Noah.
You mean cousin.
Your cousin Noah.
Mom, look, I
had
so
awesome. Oh, I love how many colors you added.
Like, how do you start building
Jenga? We can stack it in a few minutes. We're going to finish our abstract art, and then I have to double check. I think it's three across and then three horizontal.
Who's driving the train?
I'm going to add orange up here.
Mom, how
is it cross? Just do opposite directions.
Don't have to make the color.
Nice. Yeah, that's it, Dill. I know, you got it.
Mom?
And friends, next time you can put a little music on if you want, or you can do art quietly, without music.
Right, yeah.
When you're home, it's fun to do different things.
And this is Noah.
Oh, that's your box that's reminding you of your cousin Noah? That's awesome. Wow, I love it. I'm gonna put a lot of blue in this box.
Let's watch.
Here, I'll show you guys.
See, they're making one of these. They're making theirs, and you're making yours.
And look at mine. Mom, can I hold on?
Hold on. And then we'll step back, and we can see all. Oh, now we see Dylan. Dylan wants to show you Kandinsky's version, but everyone's is going to look like their own version.
That's Kandinsky.
It's not an original. That is very rare.
You made that.
How's everybody's color? Wow, Jeremy! Pretty good, Jeremy. Gosh, I love it. I love the colors, the lines, and I love that I can see some of the white paper. That looks beautiful.
I can tell you
maybe. Oh my gosh, Daniel, amazing! That is so cool! Check it out, black and white.
Let me see it.
Daniel, there were many abstract artists that worked in black and white, and a lot of them were called optic artists, and they did work that looked like, whoa, illusions. Hannah, check
it
out!
All I'm using is pen.
Oh, cool, I love that you're working in pen. That's a great medium to work in. Oh, Hannah, that's incredible. I love the colors.
I gotta finish mine. I have to finish a lot.
Oh, are you okay? Did you drop
it? I got a lot more to do, Mommy.
Wow, Avi. I love the marker and the different thicknesses and circles.
Can I finish?
That's cool, so incredible.
Very cool.
You guys, these are amazing and making my day.
The next socials are in a few weeks. Can you mark your
pen? Anna, what mediums did you use? It looked like you used crayon or marker, and maybe did you use watercolor?
I say markers and crayons, all the above.
Markers and crayons. Wow, you really filled in certain areas, and it looks like almost watercolor to me.
Can you put it on the next socials online?
No.
You guys made amazing choices. I'd love to see your artwork, and I hope you guys hang it up on the wall.